again. I'll lend you 30 if you pay me back by tomorrow.
Done. Thank you, Subi.
Someday I'll find out why you're always strapped for credits. Anything I can help with?
When did you start believing in a god?
My parents were both scientists. My home was ruled by rationality. So when I became a teenager, let's just say that while other kids found Batarian music, I found God.
But your work as a scientist?
Convinced me even more, especially when I got into molecular biology, physics. The patterns I kept seeing over and over again, they were like an artist's watermarks. God, to me, is an artist, an inventor, not someone checking to see if I brush my teeth.
I should get back to things.
Sounds good.
Hey guys, Charlie here. Welcome back to Mass Effect. I was getting a few comments, a few private messages and stuff, and asking me why I kept avoiding... They were saying I was avoiding that prompt on Suvi, and it's like I'm not avoiding it. I just already know what she's going to say, so I just didn't bother wasting time with it. But there you go. We've investigated it now. I hope you're happy. Let's take a look at Callow real quick, or check in with Callow.
Oh, the ship manual's useful. That leg of my workbench needed propping up.
If you bothered reading it, you'd know that the Tempest is an orchestra of new tech. You can't just meddle with...
I got this ship launch-ready in record time, Callow. I know my stuff.
And you don't have a shred of respect for other
people. Whoa.
Callow.
Easy.
Oh, Ryder. Sorry you had to hear that.
My guys, get along. We do have a couple of missions I'm going to do today.
You have AVP outstanding, Pathfinder.
Yes, I know. Sam continues to remind me that over and over and over and over and over again. So let's do that now. Let's get rid of that now. AVP status control is here. So let's wake somebody up. I'm kind of thinking I want commerce right now, but let's just check military perks really quick here. Consumable supplies at regular intervals, organic materials, tech materials. I mean, this stuff is good. I mean, this stuff is pretty good, but... I actually do want to get to, like, crafting stuff. More credits for Apex missions. Meh. Reveal hidden caches around established forward stations. Nexus engineers attach long-range sensors and monitoring systems to initiative forward stations. This might be valuable. I think this might be valuable, but... we actually have rewards to collect. Because our science, our lab technicians have... And we have to collect them too. They won't just keep going. So I just acquired 100 Milky Way research data. If I don't, like another 45 minutes from now, I have to click it again. And if I don't click it, it just sits here stagnant until I do. So, like, I need to stay on that, I guess. Mining operations sounds like a pretty cool thing, but I'm leaning towards going commerce because financial infrastructure sounds great. We earn just credits at regular intervals for investments. And if we get this one, we'll unlock this one, which allows us to learn a large amount of credits from investments. And if you know anything about investments like this, it's just exponential gains. The further, well, okay, it is exponential gains technically, but not in this game. It's just compounding gains. We're just going to keep getting more and more money. The earlier we activate this, the more total money we'll end up getting. Trade capacity seems like a good thing. We're starting to get close to our item limit, but I don't think it's necessary right away. I'm gonna do financial infrastructure first. Get ourselves some money. So we didn't get any money that time, I don't think, but in 45 minutes we will. So good stuff. Now Sam can stop bugging me about that. I wanna see if I can investigate or talk to Jal because I'd really like to learn more about the Angara.
Nuxul is very cunning. We can't underestimate him. My mothers are worried sick about the cousins that joined him.
I want to learn more about your species.
Yes.
What would you like to know?
Yes. Everything.
How long have you had electromagnetic capabilities? How do they evolve?
No idea. Biology doesn't interest me, but I'm sure you can easily read up on it.
That's disappointing. No biology at all?
How do your eyeballs work?
Okay, I get your point. Maybe I can find an Angara doctor to ask about your... whatever.
Although, I used to know some facts. Like, the origins of our vestigial organs.
Oh, yeah. Humans have a coccyx, a vestigial tail. And I have webbed toes, just a couple, but Sarah doesn't. And she had wisdom teeth, but I didn't. Now you.
No idea.
Okay. Like, he's just so... All right, temperament.
The Angara seem so open and free with their feelings.
Are we? We're certainly not ashamed of our feelings. We're taught that feelings and beliefs should live on the outside, where they can be dealt with, honestly and openly.
Don't people get hurt?
Of course. Then everyone deals with it. That's the point.
How many colonies do you have? On what planets?
Since the Scourge, we've managed to survive on a small number of planets. What we know from before the Scourge is mostly oral history. We did have spaceflight, and the stories tell of 5 original colonies.
You studied with Moshe Sefa. Is she a teacher or a religious figure?
She's many things. She's a clear thinker with deep knowledge and insight. She teaches and inspires. She is beloved. I love her.
Really? So one of those professor-student things?
No, not that way. Moshe Sefa is 115 of your years old.
Well, you know, honestly, that doesn't tell me much, because I don't know how old you are. But maybe we'll find that out.
Is there a central Angaran religion?
There are many variations. An almanac could give you an accurate number. But if you are a believer, the essential tenet is, after we die, we are reincarnated. We evolve to make our families strong. Born from what was before. Blessed to be better than before.
Are you a believer?
No. Yes. Sometimes. I don't know if it's the same for humans. Sahuna, my true mother, is a firm believer.
Well, enough about that. What's your story, Jal? Tell me about yourself.
Why?
Well, why wouldn't you?
Yeah.
You hiding something?
Come on, man.
Maybe.
Be friendly.
That would only make sense.
That would only make sense?
You're messing with me. Right?
Possibly. What does that mean?
Okay.
It's an idiom. It means you're joking, trying to make me feel uncomfortable.
Ah, then no. Ifra instructed me to be cautious. I'm not very good at being cautious.
I see.
Can you tell me more about the Ket occupation?
It's a difficult subject. I'll answer what I can. I may get emotional.
What's living under the Ket been like for you?
Do you really want to hear about these things? They're painful.
I asked, didn't I?
It's like living on unstable ground. Every day brings more horrible news. I part company with someone, not knowing if I'll ever see them again. When I was a boy, my father vanished from my life. One horrible day.
Was he in the Resistance?
No. He was a technician at a mine. He went to work and didn't come home. That happens for an Angara child somewhere, every single day.
When the Ket came, why didn't you fight?
They didn't give us a reason to. Until they did. Then it was too late. Perhaps you think we were weak. But the Ket are ruthless. They are masters at knowing exactly when and how to strike.
I get that. Believe me. Have the Ket always been here?
No. Some, like the Moshai, are old enough to remember the time before the Ket. But I don't. Nor do my mothers.
And the Archon came with them?
We think so. Resistance intel on that is unclear, and few have seen him in person.
And lived to tell?
And lived to tell.
Well, enough about that. I'll see you later, Jal.
Stay strong and clear.
Okay, we just learned a lot about Jahl, which is really awesome. We know that he's at least not 115 years old. He's also told us before that the Ket showed up about 80 years ago. So that would mean that his mother is not 80 years old, because his mother doesn't remember a time either. So that would suggest that Jahl is actually pretty young. I don't know exactly how old the Angara lived to be. I'm sure I'll probably find that out at some point in time. But he's at least, you know, not an old man or anything, so that's good. He seems quite intelligent anyway. Okay, so a couple of missions we're going to do today. I don't know about a couple, but I want to do this. I want to find the leader of the Rokar. And Axul, I want to find him. And I want to talk to him. So he has the Thaldir is who I have to find, actually. But this is on Havarl. And while we're there, since we're already kind of here, we just need to land again, unfortunately. But while we're there, though, we can speak with... hold on. I know it's here somewhere. Not this one. There's an assignment. I saw it. I just don't remember where it is. Ah, right here. Cross-cultural alliances. Contact Director Addison from Havarl. So she wants us to contact her, I'm assuming, from, like, I don't know, some sort of communication station that's on Havarl. So we can do both of those things. So let's head over here. Galaxy map. And we'll just go ahead and land on Havarl again. There we go. And maybe we'll bring... You see, the one thing that's annoying me a little bit, and maybe it shouldn't annoy me, but it is kind of annoying me, is that while I can select my squad mates, I have no control over what they bring into battle. Like, I can't adjust their loadout at all. So I can't give Korra something that, for instance, improves her biotics, right? Like, that would be great, but I can't do that. It doesn't let me do any of that. I wish it would. What do we want for ammo? I think Disruptor's probably fine there. Even though now I've learned that it doesn't actually help you the way I thought it helped you. It's a consumable. I have to activate it to consume, but it's fine.
Entering atmosphere, LZ in sight.
I love watching that come down. So cool. Okay, so we've got Jahl and Korra with us now. That's cool. We should be able to take on pretty much, well, any organic opponents. Since we're going to the Rokar, I assume we're going to be facing more organic enemies instead of Remnant, but I suppose I could be wrong. Where do we contact Addison? Nope. It's gonna be one of those days. There we go. Is it Helios assignments? Now I totally forgot where it is now. This. Let's make this the active target, because it's probably close by. Yeah, 30 meters away. Okay. I was hoping that we would have to do it from here. Hollow communicator.
No mutations, no fungus, all fine signs.
Some people eat plant fungus as a delicacy.
If you're going to eat something spewed out by a malfunctioning vault, at least do it on a dare.
Huh. That's interesting. Do we not have subtitles on anymore? Did that change itself somehow? It says enabled. In both places where it's located. Okay, then. Holo communicator.
The reports didn't do this world justice. It's ethereal.
Director Addison? No personal appearance? It might have been an outpost.
Thank you, but no. I prefer climate control to these extremes. Given the planet's significance to the Angara, It's appropriate that we assist, but not place an outpost. And the stability you brought? I received a thank you from Aya. That may be the first time I've heard those words in Andromeda.
After the Cat and what they've seen of the Exiles, we had to be at our best.
We've had precious few examples of that. Pathfinder might be getting close. Havarl helps. Outpost or not, we're gaining. We need another, but we're gaining. It's promising, and a lot of people have noticed. And there's another matter, a ceremonial one. A statement for the Archives.
Is this really the time?
Pathfinder was always a symbol. Like outpost flags hanging in the commons, the people need a connection to reality on the ground. Address them, Pathfinder. What did this mean?
Well, say hello to Angarad Earth. Yeah, okay.
This is Havarl. I didn't find an outpost. I found Angara and saw a piece of who they are. We're welcome to help here. It's not ours. It's all of ours. I think that makes the whole cluster closer to home.
Into the books, Pathfinder. Addison out.
Whoa! 1600 viability points for that. Viability is now increased 20%. It's now at 98%. Really? 100%. 100% viability for Havarl. Nice. Just by talking to Addison. And we have a level 5 Nexus now? That would mean we get to open 2 more sets of pods, right? We were level 3 when we just opened the other one. So I think that means we get more people released. Sounds cool. All right, before we leave Havarl, though, I do want to get additional tasks. And here, where is it? Oh, come on now. Is it no longer a task? There, this one. Okay, let's go, guys. We're gonna find the leader of that group of misfits. That's a zoom in button. That's cool. I didn't know that existed, but I can just like zoom in on anything with right click. As long as my weapons aren't out, it'll still do it. Oh, enemies. Should we engage? Kind of thinking we should. I got my abilities up. Oh, that must have hurt.
Nice work.
Yeah. Yeah. Scale fibers. Cool. Bit of nickel. Anything we can scan here? Of course not. Okay, let's continue on our path. Palev Research Station. I think that's where we're already at. I think I want a different profile here. Especially since we're going to be fighting Angara. Well, at least I thought we were. That sounds really close. Like, I can hear it not just growling, but breathing. So I'm pretty sure that's close. Hang on. I don't want to get ambushed by this thing, wherever it is. Okay, there's one of those little dog things. It's not really a dog. The Havarl version of a wolf in the woods. But that's not the big beast I hear. Well, wherever it is, it's coming at us now, right? Where is it? Huh. I guess repeated hits don't do much. There it is. Target acquired. Got a couple of those little doggies with him. Let's take those guys out first if we can.
Here they come!
Switching up. Yeah. I know it looks like I just made an explosion from my gun, but it was just good timing. That worked. I'm happy with that. Good outcomes all around. Couple of drawl here, like I don't care. Unearthed remnant device. Yes?
Historians believe much of our progress was spurred by such finds. We might benefit from collecting these artifacts.
I actually would really like to find them all. Because that's just the completionist that I kind of am. I don't really do completionist type stuff on my first playthrough. I just sort of enjoy the game and go with what's natural at all times, but, you know. I would be lying if I said there wasn't some sort of an urge to just, you know, walk around this place and see if I could find them all. Okay, well, this hut's kind of pointless. Let's continue towards our objective, which is on the other side of this little area here. So there we go. Nothing of use to us in there. Still some enemies in range. Or drawl. More of these little drawl things. No, the enemy's dead. Integrated tech. I think it's on the other side of this wall. Filaments. If I don't talk as much in this episode, it's because I have a really bad cough right now. And I'm actually just editing out all my coughing. So you're not hearing any of it, hopefully, but if I have, like, this big gap where I'm not talking, it's that's why. Sorry about that in advance.
Enemies!
Combos! Nice! Alright, let's go. Whoa. That's so cool. Like, just seeing that huge shadow come over the ground is just like. It's so intimidating.
Sophia lives near here. She's our best lead to finding Axul.
Think she'll talk to us?
It'll take some convincing, but I think so.
I need to find Axul. Let's go do this, and this. Remains. Observer lens. Moderate value. Nickel. Nothing I can scan in here. Okay. We'll head this way. We're not alone. Beat the cat. Okay.
Protect soldier.
Gotcha. Hey, you. Come join us. Say hi. Crowd control profile is doing work. Doing work. All right. There we go. Oh, this is not good. Not a good sign.
Rokar, they died fighting.
Aksul must have sent them to watch over Tholdir.
Ingara, integrated tech node. We've got lots of research points. We need to spend some of them, I think. I'm not spending any of them. I want to know what's back here. Probably nothing. Probably. Except containers. Inorganic lubricant. Low value, but we'll take it all. Should have got the organic kind. Yeah, we'll take all that stuff too. We got lots of credit potential too here. That combined with the investments, we're gonna have some pretty good money, I think, coming in. Which should be good for upgrading our gear because, well, honestly, I don't know. Like, if I can't equip my teammates with better gear, then, I mean, what does it matter? Like, how would I ever run out of supplies?
Locked. I'll override it.
Because it's just that easy.
Don't come any closer.
Tholdir, we're here to help.
That's why we have our gun on, my guns on you. That's exactly why I was pointing a gun at you. Let's scan the room real quick. Yep, what's this? Got a console and a data pad. Translated from Shalesh, how did our lives come to this? How could our ancestors let the Ket conquer our world so easily? And why do our present leaders fail to protect us now? Disunity destroys us from within. Our people have repeatedly failed to join forces when we needed them most. They've blamed each other, bickered and betrayed, and given our conquerors easy prey. Now we see a new enemy invading our space, offering extinction disguised as hope. Disguised as hope. Lies meant to divide us. It falls on those who can see past these deceptions to prevent our people from repeating the mistakes that doomed us in the past. All Angara must become one to have any hope of defeating the evil forces surrounding us. This is the single belief of the Rokar, and I feel its truth in my blood. Our cause is just. Well, if you want to unite, if you want to unified, maybe you should have, you know, not tried to divide. Nightmares. To Aksul from Tholdir, I dreamt of the camps again. I thought one couldn't feel pain in dreams, but I did. My back ached from exhaustion, and my skin stung from where they cut me. Even after I awoke, I could feel the Ket in my scars. All I want is to sleep. From Aksul. Tarashe, I'm sending you a bottle of Dreamager. It should help with the nightmares. I use it myself from time to time. I know I promised not to bring it up again, but I wish you could come stay at one of our camps. Havarl's jungles are dangerous. I don't like the idea of you alone out there, and it would be nice to have you near. Please think about it again. To Aksul from Tholdir, I don't deserve your thoughtfulness. I know you would love to join the Rokar to fight by your side. Oh, you know I would love to join the Rokar to fight by your side, but the shaking returns whenever I'm around strangers. It's better if I stay here. Thank you for the Dreamager. Last night was the first time in months I did not dream of the Ket. It seems you have saved me again, Tanavan.
Don't touch me.
I just want to help.
Your wounds, they're self-inflicted?
The cat. I can't go back. I won't.
Oh. Hush now, sister. The cat are dead. They can't take you. We won't let them.
You sound like him. So confident. So sure.
You mean Axel?
He saved me. Gave me a chance to live. And die on my own terms.
We need to find him, Thordir. Ishare, brave one.
Her last words were of Axul. We're back to square one.
We're no closer to Axul.
Her devotion to him surprised me. I don't think anyone affiliated with the Rokar will help us. The only other person who could reach him is the Moshai.
Another reason to rescue her.
Come on, let's go.
Yep. I knew we'd eventually get around to rescuing her. You know, the leader guy or whatever that won't like us. We had to prove ourselves to him. He was always like, you know, she's been captured and our attempts failed. As soon as he said that, I was like, yeah, well, because of how uninventive BioWare is going to be in the narrative flow of this, absolutely they're going to say, oh, eventually you get to go rescue her. I mean, that's just the natural progression of things. It's not really something that required invention, you know, from a narrative standpoint, but it's just what made sense. I don't think you need a film degree necessarily to see that. Another unearthed remnant device.
This is coming back to the Tempest.
See what I mean? Like, I'm sitting here thinking to myself, I want to find all these. If I activate a quest of some kind, would that... See, this is on hold now. I have to wait for the meeting, so never mind. On hold, Outpost Worlds, on hold, Missing Arcs, still, not, can't really do that yet. This I need to go to Eos for, this I need to go to Vold for, this I need to go back to the Hyperion for, and this here I need to go to the Nexus for. So all of those are at someplace else. I don't have anything for Havarl here. And Priority Ops tells us to go to Vold. So there's nothing else really left to do here. Except for finding the manifestos, which if I do that, is it going to tell me where they are on the map? No, it's not going to tell me where they are. Which I like that. Like, I don't get me wrong. I like the fact that it's not going to tell me where they are. I have to find them myself. I like that. Medical supplies found. This is interesting. I do want to find this. Because the medical supplies, I want to find this, but it says, meant for initiative outposts, you've been asked to hit outlaw bases and reclaim them for redistribution. Where are the bases? That's something I don't know. I don't think they're here. Yeah, I have to go back to the Tempest. So let's just go to a forward station and get back on the Tempest, I guess. What's this icon here? It's a merchant. Well, we might as well see what he's got to sell, right? Let's go this way. Let's just see what the merchant has for sale. Got another quest icon up here, actually. Another quest marker. So, we're gonna go talk to that person, too. Come on up! There we go. It's this way. They're up on top of the platform.
Cluster analysis alone can't tell us anything useful. Our sample set is much too narrow.
Well, you need me to go and get you more samples, don't you?
Pathfinder Ryder, Dr. Tisana Relar, xenobotanist for the Initiative, and my colleague, Dr. Eric Baumgarten.
Xenogenetics. Pleasure to meet you.
All right, this world is your toy box.
I can see why you're on Havarl. Plenty to keep you busy.
Indeed. It can hardly walk without stepping on a new life form. We tread lightly.
Your report of accelerated evolution and rapid growth of nature here caught our interest.
We're analyzing everything we can for clues to replicate the effects on our own crops.
What a terrible idea. Why would I think that that is a terrible idea? I don't understand.
It would have interesting applications if there's a way to control the process.
You understand the end goal.
If we learn to enhance the growth of plants and animals in non-destructive ways, we could end hunger. It would change everything for the Initiative. Our colonies could thrive virtually overnight.
Since you repaired the vault, things are returning to normal, but too quickly for us.
The accelerated life forms you want to study are dying off. Decaying.
We're scrambling to scan and catalog everything before it's gone. We could use some help.
All right.
Point me at the life forms you need. I'll do the rest.
Anything mutated beyond its baseline growth cycle will aid our work.
I'll provide the most promising genetic markers to scan for.
Thank you for whatever help you can provide, Pathfinder. Rendezvous here when you're finished.
I don't know, I kind of want to do that. I kind of want to do that for them. Just saying. I know that's probably not the most interesting thing in the world, but... you know, kind of do. It doesn't look like it's going to give me anything on the map here. I am tracking the right quest, am I not? Pretty sure. Overgrown. Cross-reference genetic markers with known creature dens. Oh, right. So I need to go over here, and it will tell me where the dens are of where I've already been, and what to scan for from the places I've already been to. Since I've been pretty much everywhere, that should be a good thing, I think. Let's,
Chances of all would have blasted another cycle.
Those guys are so loud. Mutated Chalorin. Chalurian. A Chalurian of abnormal size and aggressiveness is decimating local wildlife. The nav point for the beast's hunting grounds has been uploaded to you. Recommend approaching with extreme caution. The Chalurian is likely to consider you a threat. It may be curious how you taste. Right. Okay. Mutated Rylcor. The malfunctioning remnant vault appears to have modified a Rylcor to be more territorial and adaptable. It has been observed defending its feeding grounds at the nav point uploaded to you. Scans of the Rylcor may reveal the nature of its mutations. And then an Irox. This is the big guy. The big armored thing. Bearing physical and behavioral signs of genetic modification by Havarl's remnant vault has made its home near the nav point just uploaded to you. Scans of the creature should reveal its nature, the nature of its mutations and how they altered the beast from its baseline. Okay. So we've got three nav points then. Based on places we've already been and stuff, we've got three baselines. Most of them are just like, yeah, they're all just creatures. So we just go and kill the beasts. We're going hunting. Which one are we going to hunt for first? I think we just work our way this way, I guess. So let's go for this one over here first. This is the Chalurin, then the Rylcor, and then the big guys over here. So let's go. Looks like he's got a couple friends with him, too. According to my nav point, it looks like he's got a couple of friends with him. Well, that's a draw. There's a draw, anyway.
Main shot.
Yeah, of course I missed. I'm not smart enough to aim up when I need to. It's okay. I'll just punch it.
We've got targets!
Where? Where are the targets? Over here? They're active already? It's only 30 meters. Now... I was gonna say, like, where is it? I don't see it. That's the scan I need. Keep him busy, guys. Hitting the button, but it's not working. Oh, here we go. Because I didn't have my weapon out. When I took my scanner, it's the wrong button. I'm just hitting the wrong buttons, that's all. I am the champion of hitting the wrong buttons. My singularity button on my mouse is right next to the scan button, so I'm kind of prone to doing one or the other.
Pathfinder, the life forms in this area display accelerated growth markers.
Yep, another scan. That's good. Okay, so time to go to the next one. That was fun. Now, I think the next two actually have armor. I think. I'm not positive on that, but I think they do. So I'm going to switch to this profile here just to get the cooldowns going. Because I recognize the names, and I think the one is like the dinosaur-looking thing, and then the one is the really big guy. So both of those creatures, to my memory, have armor. This place is so cool. 100% viability. Our first vibe, first 100%. We need to get Eos to do the same thing. Because that's like the human colony right there, you know? Get another outpost on Eos and get military there. So it can protect itself better. I hear something.
The initiative researchers might benefit from scans of the mutated wildlife nearby.
There's a lot of wildlife nearby. I'd like to know exactly what I'm dealing with. Come on now. Okay, so there's a bunch of those little Chalaran things. I think we take those things out first, because I don't want to deal with them. They can't get up here, so it's kind of an opportunity to just take them out from here. At least I thought they can't come up here. I suppose it's possible they can, but I don't think they can. I hear something big nearby, though. That's certainly something. That's a big guy, yeah. It's coming up here. Slowly but surely, it makes its way up here. Where are they? What is she fighting? Like, I thought the enemies were all over here. Hi. A lot more around here, but you know what? I think they're all...
You apart.
Low ammo. It's okay, I don't need ammo. I kind of do, but it's okay. Got the scans.
Okay.
shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. What is that? Oh my god. I've never seen that before. Oh, what is that? What is that? Okay. Okay. That's cool. So that's the guy that was shooting me from a distance. Come on, get rid of his shield. Rid of his shield. Got him. Where is it? There it is.
Clean shot.
I think we're good. I think we're good here. Okay, final enemy is that way. And that is the other armored thing. Like, this thing is so stupid. Come on, powers. I need my abilities. Thank you. Hey, big hoss. Jesus. There's people shooting me, aren't they? Oh my gosh. What is happening? Like, what is after me? I hate not knowing. Alright. We're up to somewhat more safety now, but like, where is this thing?
Reload!
Oh great, snipers are back. It's those long, long range snipers that really get me. Where are they? It's those really long range guys. Ticking me off, man. Where are, yeah, look at them. Just sniping me from way over there, somewhere. Can't fight him, he's got armor. Well, I can fight him, but like, god, my shields are already gone. They just attack me so quick, I can't respond to it fast enough. Oh shit. Really? Oh my god! What? Enemies everywhere! Yeah, there's just no chance. They're sniping me from so far away, and they're all around me. So far away right now. They don't care. They're hitting me anyway. Hold on. Reset here. What in the hell is happening? I have no ammo at all. And there's like 50 enemies around me right now. I need to be smart about this. But it's kind of hard to be smart when you can't see them. Where? Ryder, get up on top of that ledge. Where is the sniper? Where is the sniper? I hope the sniper's fighting the remnant. If the sniper was fighting the remnant, that would make me happy. Isn't there a forward station close by? Yeah, right here. I need ammo. Hook me up. There we go. Reload. Didn't you just do that? Come on. Let's go find this guy. I mean, there's a couple of them, but there he is. There. Come on. Get him. Got him. Flamethrower is silly, but whatever. So the saboteur is dead, armored with a sniper rifle. Great. Thanks for that. Big guy's still alive somewhere. This is not on task at all. There's just so many threats here. This area is just super dangerous. I think I made him mad. Hi guys. Don't mind us. Just gonna take the remains and go. No problems. Don't want any trouble here. Thanks. Have a nice day. Can we get this other thing now? Can we get the other things now? I'd like to. Unless these guys are more enemies that I can't stand. I know we're not alone. We're never alone in this jungle. A little bit of nickel.
Loading ammo!
Okay, where is this thing?
That's a long way to fall.
Yes, it is, but we need to go to the other side. So I need the bridge. Going hunting is fun, right? It's just sort of like a big combat episode, pretty much, with a little bit of learning, in the beginning. Yeah, I need to go further in. Let's just do this. This is much faster. Okay. So there's remnant everywhere. That's good. We're gonna go this way. I know we're not alone. I wonder if I can be killed near my forward station. Like, I wonder if I can even be... if I can even be damaged while I'm at my forward station. Because this station replenishes my shields. So, like, can they even kill me here? I think this is a safe zone. Every time I reload, I would just get ammo back, wouldn't I? Nope, I can totally be hit here. I can totally be injured inside my zone there.
Enemies!
Oh! Fancy. Wrong button.
that's it. Good work.
Okay, full shields, full health, full ammo. Let's go.
Hostiles.
There's always hostiles. Always. They missed. Let you miss. Let's go forward. Eventually we'll get to the final enemy. The final hunt. Sounds like there's a bunch of Rokar up here shooting at it. Definitely something shooting at it.
This is coming back to the Tempest.
Oh yeah, there's Rokar all over this place. They don't even see us. They're too busy dealing with the mutated thing. They see us now. Hi. Stronger than usual. Let's deal with the Rokar now. Is that not the right one? Really? I need a very specific one.
These Angara carried more than weapons. They had research tech, data pads. Let's find out why.
Interesting. Did this quest just lead to a new one? I think it did. But what happened to the beast I was supposed to scan? Like, we killed it over there, but it didn't, like, not letting me scan anything. Translated from Shalesh, close to confirming Varen's theory, we found correlating mutations of both animal and plant life, indicating a singular mechanism tailored to variant cellular and genetic structures. Estimated 82% chance the mutant strains ravaging Havarl can be replicated elsewhere, allowing us to introduce this toxic process to other planetary biomes. If Varen is correct, we may even improve on the process, generating more destructive effects on reduced timelines. We could render any world poisonous to outsiders and drive them away for good. No more Ket, no more initiative, only our worlds and our people as it should be.
The Rokar were studying mutant wildlife too. They want to use it against us. The datapad mentions a camp.
Updating known data. Mission parameters changing.
Nice. So we don't have to scan the beast anymore? Is that what you're saying? Because now we have a new objective. And that is to investigate something else. N- Now we are going to investigate the Rokar camp. Yep. So this quest just turned into something completely different. Where is that located? Way over here. Well, that camp might also lead us to someplace else, and then that might lead us to someplace else. Could be an interesting thing. I think I'm going to leave the episode here. When we come back, we'll investigate this camp. That sounds like a fun time, doesn't it? This episode's getting pretty long, so I kind of want to keep these episodes around an hour. If I can, I mean, Mass Effect's a huge game, so you can't do things very quickly, but I'm going to try and keep things about an hour or less if possible, so I'll head on over to that camp, and we'll pick up the next episode from there. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.